Alright guys, welcome back to another MCreator procedure tutorial. So today what we're going to be looking at is block directions and a couple ways that you can actually do it, probably the most common ones, and then we'll be just quickly doing an example. But before we get started, if you have a custom block, what you're going to want to do is make sure that you have rotation enabled for this to work. So if we go into the block on the first page under visual, there's a block rotation mode right at the top here, and you can select from a few different options. There's southwest, northeast, player side, which is going to rotate the block similar to a loom, for example, follows the same logic. So you would basically do that. There is the down, up, north, south, west, east one, which is very similar to buttons. It will place it based on the one of those, any side of the block. There's also the block face. So if you want to have it rotate according to the block face that it's being clicked on, like if you're facing, you click on the north side, then it will automatically rotate it facing north. You can do it with these two down here. And the log rotation mimics the log rotation of logs in the game. Some blocks like logs, or I think the pillar blocks for quartz also use this mechanic. So it basically just sets a default direction on one direction facing the X, Y, or Z rotation parameters. So all those are the ones that you need for enabling block rotation. You don't have it set, then it will always return a default direction, and that probably won't be very helpful for this tutorial. So one last thing I want to quickly make a note of is you can use local variables for direction. You can set the direction to something like block A and store the directions directly to this variable. So block B, we'll be using these two in our script later on, so you can set the direction to them. They're orange by default because that's the color of the rotation blocks. So the two major blocks that you're probably going to be using the most are under actions and data. So the first one, if we scroll down to the bottom here, we can set the block direction, which is set direction of block at X, Y, and Z to, and then the direction that we want to set it to. It's set to down for default. You can click on the direction block and it will give you a list of different directions. It's the six sides by default. The other block that is most commonly used in my procedures, though there's a few other methods that we can actually do, like through block states and stuff like that, but I won't get into too much detail right now because that could use its own separate video. But we have get block direction. This one allows you to set the block direction directly, or you can also get the block direction and replace the provided block state with this. And this will actually not require the provided block direction if you use it this way, but it will require the X, Y, and Z. So this method works with the update tick triggers for the block, so you can actually do that rather than having a other dependency. In most cases, this will probably work in most procedures. There is another block in the data one. If we scroll all the way down, there is get block direction, which does exactly the same thing as the setup right up here. To test for a direction, what you would want to do is go under the logic tab, and there is an orange block down here that you can test and compare two different directions. So let's go ahead and assign the rotation to block A and block B, and I'm going to use both of these methods just to show that it's exactly the same. So we're going to go ahead and grab the other parameter here, and I'm going to set this one as the default one, and then this is going to be block B, and we're going to test for the block directly above. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use these two variables for our test down below. So we need an if statement for this one, and then we can go into our variables, get variable A is variable A equal to variable B. And then what we can go ahead and do is we're going to test if it's not equal to, and we're going to go ahead and rotate it. Well, we have a bunch of other options up here. We can actually set the opposite direction of that, or we can set it on clockwise. I think I'm going to go with the clockwise one, and we're going to get the rotation of the block B, and we're going to set the rotation to the next one. So we're going to keep doing that until it reaches the same rotation as the block A version. And because this is going to run on a right click, and a lot of the blocks that are have rotation that I'm going to be testing with are actually going to have an inventory, like a chest or whatever, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just cancel the event quickly, because it does support canceling down here. As you can see under the right click block, it says cancelable. So we can actually use this block here in the global procedure to basically prevent the GUI from being opened. So let's go ahead and save this and we'll pop in game quickly. All right, so I've actually made a fatal mistake for what I was going to do. And because we're testing for the block direction one block above, we also want to set the block direction one block above here. So what we're going to do is, what we were doing before was rotating the block that we had clockwise, which was actually not what I was intending to do. So we're going to just basically go ahead and set the block above to rotate rather than the current block that it is. So this should all work now. So let's go in game and quickly test this out now. That is correct. All right, so we have a couple different blocks here. We have a couple chests, and if we go ahead and click on it, you can see that it rotates around, and then we can finally open up the block when we right click on it. So let's go ahead and just remove those so we can actually see what we're doing. So currently this block, if we look in the F3 screen, it says facing and then south. So that is the block state property, facing, and the value of that property is currently south for this block. The one below is east. If we right click on the east one, the direction up here will change to west. So you can see that it's now facing west. And if we right click again, it'll be on this side. So now it's facing north. And if we right click again, it'll be facing east. Now we can actually open up the chest now that this condition is the same direction. So we can basically rotate the chest around based on the direction of the current block, and it will keep rotating around like that. Hopefully this helps. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and let me know in the comments what you liked about it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching. Peace out.